Hello everyone, a fruit hook cancer carcinogenesis theory and molecular mechanisms, volume 6, second part, molecular carcinogenesis, Efruz Asiloğlu, independent researcher. Fats are broadly divided into saturated and polyunsaturated classes. Within the polyunsaturated category are two families of essential fatty acid, EFA. Essential because the body needs them but can't manufacture them from other sources in the diet or from other fats. These EFAs are 1. The omega-6 linoleic acid and its derivative gamma linoleic acid, linolenic acid, present in evening primrose oil, and 2. The omega-3 alpha linolenic acid family, present in fish and linseed oils. Depending on the type of dietary fat eaten, one of several different pathways result, leading to the synthesis of either prostaglandin or leukotriene families of molecules called eicosanoids, resulting in immune-enhancing anti-inflammatory, anti-cancer, and anti-clotting properties, or alternatively inflammatory action involving leukotriene synthesis. Prostaglandins and leukotrienes are synthesized from arachidonic acid. Prostaglandins are involved in a broad range of biological activities, including smooth muscle, contraction, secretion, blood flow, reproduction, platelet function, respiration, nerve impulse transmission, fat metabolism, immune responses. They also have roles in inflammation, neoplasia, cancer promoting, fever intensifying, pain, thromboxane. A modified prostaglandin constricts blood vessels and promotes platelet aggregation. Leukotrienes stimulate chemotaxis of white blood cells and mediate inflammation factors and considerations relating to the fate and role of some of these eicosanoids. Ramesh and colleagues, Hyderabad, India, report that evening primrose oil kills tumor cells is association with a threefold increase in superoxide free radical generation, the mechanism of EPO. Tumoricidal action may involve the ability of fatty acids to bind to protein and prevent cytotoxic action. Black and Colleagues Veterans Affairs Medical Center, Houston, showed that a high corn oil omega-6 diet significantly enhances UV-induced cancer in mice that switching to a low corn oil diet after UV initiation negates the enhancing effect, and that an omega-3 diet inhibits UV cancer even at high dietary levels. Arachidonic acid N6 content was reduced by 50% and EPA DHA increased 3- to 5-fold, and tumor prostaglandin E2 levels were reduced 7.4-fold, possibly a factor in tumor growth inhibition. EPA significantly reduced protein degradation without affecting protein synthesis. Takata and colleagues, Osaka, Japan, found that EPA significantly reduced 60% versus 93.3% mammary tumor incidence and number in rats, and significantly reduced prostaglandin levels, suggesting that the breast cancer inhibition by EPA may be mediated via lipid metabolism and associated reduction in prostaglandin synthesis. Properties of essential fatty acids are cytotoxic to cancer cells either through modulation in prostaglandin synthesis, lipid metabolism, or peroxidation in the fish oil patients. Rectal, mucosal, eicosa, pentanoic acid content increased, whereas arachidonic acid levels decreased. The anti-cancer activity appears to be mediated by one or more of several mechanisms. One, direct morsidal action of EFA due to an increase in the generation of free radicals in tumor cells. Two, the ability of omega-3 fatty acids to inhibit UV carcinogenesis, although not during the post-initiation stage. 3. Reduction of tumor prostaglandin E2 level by omega-3 fatty acid. 4. Ability to suppress peroxide formation from unsaturated fatty acids. 5. Ability to inhibit tumor-induced lipolysis, anti-cachexia. 6. Reduction of linoleic and arachidonic acid and tumor lipids. Elevated plasma prostaglandin E2 and monocyte interleukin 10 production are associated with NSCLC. The biological significance to elevated prostaglandin E2 levels in NSCLC, non-small cell lung cancer, that means, are unclear. Further investigation of each as a non-specific marker for non-small cell lung cancer tumor is warranted one mechanism by which tumors evade immune destruction is through cytokine production or induction. Prostaglandin E2 constitutively produced by many non-small cell lung cancer has been identified as one factor that has direct immunosuppressive properties and is known to induce interleukin-10 in mononuclear cells. Interleukin-10 is a dominant immunosuppressive cytokine found in the non-small cell lung cancer environment, known to directly affect T-cell mediated immunity. Both prostaglandin E2 and interleukin-10 have been shown to suppress antigen presentation, to suppress cytotoxic T cell responses, and to inhibit cytokine production by T cells and antigen presenting cells. Perhaps most importantly, interleukin-12 that plays a central role in the initiation and potentiation of cellular immune responses. Prostaglandin E2 levels and/or interleukin-10 levels were elevated in plasma of non-small cell lung cancer patients. Whether monocytes from NC adherent cells, predominantly mononuclear phagocytes from 13 individuals, were evaluated for interleukin-10 production. Data show adherent mononuclear cells from non-small cell lung cancer patients produce baseline levels of interleukin-10 significantly greater than those of normal volunteer. COX-2 is an inducible enzyme upregulated in inflammatory status. Notably, many non-small cell lung cancer and what have been characterized as premalignant lung lesions have been shown to constitutively express the COX-2 enzyme and produce prostaglandin E2. The primary product of the COX-2 pathway, importantly, prostaglandin E2 production by tumor cells has been linked to tumor-induced immunosuppression in non-small cell lung cancer. Prostaglandin E2 has been shown to directly suppress T-cell mediated immunity, the primary effector against tumor cells at a variety of levels. Further, prostaglandin E2 has been shown to induce the interleukin-10 in mononuclear cells. Interleukin-10 is a prominent immunosuppressive cytokine that may have a dominant role in preventing innate antitumor responses in the non-small small cell lung cancer environment. Among myriad suppressive effects on T cells and antigen presenting cells, interleukin-10 is known to inhibit interleukin-12 production. Interleukin-12 plays a key role in the initiation and potentiation of producing function in circulating mononuclear phagocytes may be a critical factor in suppressed T cell immunity to non-small cell lung cancer. Prostaglandin E2 can be induced by a number of inflammatory conditions. However, no single factor other than cancer is likely to account for the significant differences. Receptor could be EP2 drugs that block the prostaglandin E2 receptor. Receptor system, from his long-standing interest in the biological effects of prostaglandins, a family of locally acting hormones produced by the cyclooxygenase enzymes. COX enzymes are the targets of aspirin and other non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, which work to relieve pain and inflammation by blocking the production of prostaglandin. It was known that tumor tissue produces the prostaglandin E2. Breyer said blocking the EP2 receptor would be useful strategy to improve immune system killing of tumor cells. He said Revi has carried out tests by irradiating mice while feeding the mice both polyunsaturated and saturated fats at high and low levels. The interesting result from this research was that the mice which were not given any polyunsaturated fats did not get skin cancer. They were totally protected from skin cancer. She also found that as soon as they fed back polyunsaturated fats in a normal diet, the skin cancer appeared on all of the mice. This result indicated that the absence of polyunsaturated fat doesn't prevent the creation of the potential cancer cell in the skin. Absence of polyunsaturated fat somehow inhibits the whole processes of cancer development. After sun exposure, it seems to be dependent upon substances called prostaglandins, which are formed from polyunsaturated fats in the body, and if there is a deficiency in these prostaglandins, the tumors won't grow. Polyunsaturated fat, whether it's eaten in low concentrations or high concentrations, seems to be associated with a higher risk of getting skin cancer. The prostaglandin equivalents, which are produced from the fish oil type of polyunsaturators, are different and have different biological activity. The role of prostaglandin together seem to be a vast regulatory mechanism which control many functions. Prostaglandins in the development of cancer is not fully understood by scientists. It is suspected that they might be involved in immune regulation and somehow be involved in the inability of the immune system to recognize tumor cells. Tumor cells are foreign cells, and under normal conditions, the immune system would recognize and kill those cells. But when a tumor grows successfully, something has happened that has impaired the capacity of the immune system to recognize the tumor cells. Revi thinks that the prostaglandins are involved in some way. According to Kearney, it is the unchecked inflammatory processes which play a major role in the progress of a wide variety of diseases in man, including cancer-saturated fats and partially heterogenated fats contain arachidonic acid, which is a precursor to hormone-like product. In the body called prostaglandin 2, this prostaglandin of series 2 is pro-inflammatory in the body and can potentially promote breast cancer. Omega-6 vegetable oils such as corn, sunflower, soy, grain, and safflower are essential in small amounts in the diet, but in excess will shunt from the anti-inflammatory prostaglandin 1 to the pro-inflammatory prostaglandin 2. Omega-9 vegetable oil such as olive are the best soil to cook with because it is a stable monounsaturated fat that does not easily denature in heat. Omega-3 oils from flax seeds, other seeds, fish nuts, and beans is the precursor to the anti-inflammatory prostaglandin 3. These oils are polyunsaturated and are not good for cooking because they denature in just a little heat. Omega-3 fatty acids not only help prevent inflammation but also immune and endocrine problems and help prevent tumor formation. Breast cancer found that those who had low level of alpha-linolenic acid were at a higher risk for a cancer to spread to other parts of the body. The herbicide amitrol 3-amino-1,2,4-triazole has been found to cause cancer of the thyroid in rats and mice. It is thought that its mode of action may be due to hormone imbalance and prolonged stimulation of the glandular tissue. Thus, amitrol has been considered to act as an epigenetic carcinogen, that is, by a mechanism that does not directly affect the genetic material, DNA. Recent evidence has indicated that amitrol may be metabolized by the enzyme prostaglandin H synthetase to intermediates that bind to nucleic acid and proteins. Both nitric oxide and prostaglandin are produced by the processes of inflammation. Prostaglandin J2, an oxidative product of D2, was found to suppress nitric oxide synthase I induction in macrophages stimulated by LPS lipoxygenase. This finding was further analyzed and the ligand of the nuclear receptor PPARD was found to inhibit the induction in connection to the hypoxic reaction, which is critical for tumor progression. Nitric oxide produced by either tumor cells or surrounding tissue could be a determining factor of tumor vascular formation. The mechanisms of apoptosis resistance were found to be at least in part due to inhibition of caspase 3 and caspase 9 activation. Unpublished data. It was shown that nitric oxide is produced when cells and tissues are exposed to hypoxia, DNA damaging agents, and nutrient deficiency. These results suggest that nitric oxide may act as an source signaling mediator. Higher intakes of vitamin E, vitamin C, and calcium with a lower incidence of colon cancer, as well low blood level of beta-carotene, are consistently associated with an increased risk of developing colon cancer. Selenium supplementation also decreases the formation of certain cancer permissive eicosanoids of the prostaglandin E2 series. Calcium and vitamin D may reduce risk of colon cancer. Folic acid is required to help the body convert homocysteine to methionine. Once formed, methionine is readily converted to S-adenosylmethionine, which is necessary to form the DNA that makes up our genetic blueprints for life. If folic acid levels become suboptimal, then the amount of S-adenosylmethionine declines. This results in an inability to properly produce DNA as cells replace themselves from one gene generation to the next. Vitamin E also inhibits the formation of the dangerous prostaglandin mini hormone known as prostaglandin E2. High levels of prostaglandin E2 are linked to increased risk of colon cancer because it encourages the rapid division and growth of tumor cells, and it helps cancer cells escape surveillance by the body's immune system that would otherwise kill cancer cells in the normal course of events. By suppressing the formation of prostaglandin E2, vitamin E helps prevent tumor cells from growing and spreading and enables the immune system to function more effectively. Basic gene, the role of two integrins in regulation of inflammatory mediator in human cartilage. Preliminary studies show that rodent and human chondrosarcoma release pro-inflammatory angiogenic factors, such as prostaglandin E2 in vivo. In vivo, their scent role of COX-2 mediated prostaglandin E2 in progression of colon and breast cancer. Inflamed lungs. Lung, colon, liver, and uterine cancer are all usually associated with chronic inflammation. Aspirin seems to reduce the inflammation and also performs another important function. It speeds up apoptosis or cell death. Mutated cells of 10 lose the ability to commit suicide as the body tries to instruct cells that go every to do. Aspirin is known to shut down the body's production of prostaglandin substances that cause inflammation and which may also fuel tumor growth. Tumors produce large amounts of prostaglandin, which acts as a tumor promoter. Prostaglandin brings in new blood vessels, which then feed the tumors. When this happens, they become hidden from the immune system. This renders the immune system and turns off the built-in mechanism that tells cancer cells to self-destruct when they become old, hurt, or defective. Turning off prostaglandin production not only deprives the tumor of the blood supply it needs to grow, but also restores the built-in suicide mechanism in the cells. Molecular biochemistry, prostaglandins and related compounds are local hormones that are synthesized from the polyunsaturated fatty acid arachidonate. They have specific effects on target cell close to their site of formation. They are rapidly degraded, so they are not transported to distal sites within the body. Examples include prostaglandins, prostacyclins, thromboxanes, leukotrienes, and epoxy eicosatrienic acid. They have roles in inflammation, fever regulation of blood pressure, blood clotting, control of reproductive processes, and tissue growth, and regulation of the sleep-wake cycle. Prostaglandin receptors, prostaglandins and related compounds are transported out of the cell that synthesize them. Most affect other cells by interacting with plasma membrane, G-protein coupled receptors. Depending on the cell type, the activated G-protein may stimulate or inhibit formation of cyclic AMP, or may activate a phosphatidylinositol signal pathway, leading to intracellular calcium release. Another prostaglandin receptor, designated PPAR gamma is related to a family of nuclear receptor with transcription factor activity. Prostaglandins and related compounds are collectively known as eicosanoids. They are produced from arachidonic acid, a 20-carbon polyunsaturated fatty acid, 5-8-11-14, eicosatetraenoic acid. The fatty acid arachidonate is frequently esterified at the hydroxyl on C2 of glycerophospholipids, especially phosphatidyl inositol. Arachidonate is released from phospholipids by hydrolysis sites of hydrolytic cleavage by phospholipases A2 and C phospholipase A2 hydrolyzes. The ester linkage between a fatty acid and the hydroxyl at carbon 2 of the glycerol backbone. Corticosteroids are anti-inflammatory because they inhibit phospholipase A2 reducing arachidonate release. Phosphatidyl inositol signal cascades may lead to release of arachidonate. After phosphatidyl inositol is phosphorylated to pipe 2 cleavage of pipe 2 via phospholipase C yields diacylglycerol and IP3. Arachidonate released from diacylglycerol is then catalyzed by diacylglycerol lipase, prostaglandin H2 synthase. Prostaglandin H2 synthase catalyzes the committed step in the cyclic pathway that leads to production of prostaglandin. Prostacyclines and thromboxanes. Different cell types convert prostaglandin H2 to different compounds. Prostaglandin H2 synthase is a heme-containing deoxygenase bound to endoplasmic reticulum membranes. A deoxygenase incorporates oxygen molecule into a substrate. Prostaglandin H2 synthase exhibit two catalytic activities, cyclooxygenase and peroxidase. The enzyme expressing both activities is sometimes referred to as cyclooxygenase, abbreviated COX. The interacting cyclooxygenase and peroxidase reaction pathways are complex. Peroxide, such as that generated later in the reaction sequence, oxidizes the heme iron. The oxidized heme accepts an electron from a nearby tyrosine residue. The resulting tyrosine radical is proposed to extract a hydrogen atom from arachidonate, generating a radical species that reacts with oxygen molecule. The signal molecule nitric oxide may initiate prostaglandin synthesis by reacting with superoxide anion to produce peroxynitrite, which oxidizes the heme iron, enabling electron transfer from the active site. Tyrosine prostaglandin synthesis is response to some inflammatory stimuli is diminished by inhibitors of nitric oxide synthase. Arachidonate derived from membrane lipid approaches the heme via a hydrophobic channel extending from the membrane binding domain of the enzyme. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs such as aspirin and derivatives of ibuprofen inhibit cyclooxygenase activity of prostaglandin H2 synthase. They inhibit formation of prostaglandins involved in fever. Inflammatory. They inhibit blood clotting by blocking thromboxane formation in blood platelet. Ibuprofen and related compounds act by blocking the hydrophobic channel by which arachidonate and enter the cyclooxygenase active site. Aspirin acetylates a serine residue near the cyclooxygenase active site. This prevents binding of arachidonate. The inhibition by aspirin is irreversible. COX-2 expression is stimulated by growth factors, cytokines, endotoxin. COX-2 levels in increase in inflammatory disease status such as arthritis and cancer. Upregulation of COX-2 is responsible for the increased formation of prostaglandins associated with inflammation. Cancer cells express elevated COX-2, the first step of the linear pathway for synthesis of leukotrienes, is catalyzed by lipoxygenase. Mammalian organisms have a family of lipoxygenase enzymes that catalyze oxygenation of various polyunsaturated fatty acids at different sites. Many of the products have signal roles. 5-lipoxygenase found in leukocytes catalyzes conversion of arachidonate to 5-HPETE. 5-hydroxy, peroxy, eicosa, tetraenoic acid. And this is then converted to various leukotrienes that induce inflammation and asthmatic constriction of the bronchioles. Cytochrome P450 epoxygenase pathways, epoxy eicosadrienoic acid EET and hydroxy eicosadrienoic acid are formed from arachidonate by enzymes of the cytochrome P450 family. Other members of the cytochrome P450 family participate in a variety of oxygenation reactions, including hydroxylation of sterols. EETs are modified by other enzyme-catalyzed reactions to produce many distant compounds that have role in regulating cellular proliferation, inflammation, peptide hormone secretion, and various cellular signal pathways relevant to cardiovascular and renal functions. Suppression of nitric oxide production in lipopolysaccharide stimulated macrophage cells by W3 polyunsaturated fatty acids although nitric oxide is an important biological mediator, its excessive production in inflammation is thought to be a causative factor in cellular injury and cancer development. Special offers: sesame seed oil has been used as a healing oil. It is a natural anti-inflammatory agent. In vitro, sesame seed oil has inhibited the growth of malignant melanoma, a skin cancer, prostaglandin, leukotrienes, and essential fatty acids 46, 45, 150 in 1992. Also, in vitro, sesame seed oil has inhibited replication of human colon cancer cells. Sesame seed oil is a potent antioxidant in the tissues beneath the skin. This oil will neutralize oxygen radicals. It penetrates into the skin quickly and enters the bloodstream through the capillaries. Molecules of sesame seed oil maintain good cholesterol and lower blood cholesterol. Sesame seed oil is a cell growth regulator and slows down cell growth and replication in both the small intestine and the colon. Some cells are nourished by fat instead of sugar. The presence of sesame seed oil can provide those cells with essential nourishment. It is a useful natural UV protector. Sesame seed oil helps neutralize the flood of oxygen radicals, which such treatment inevitably causes. Anti-inflammatory levels of aspirin and salicylate inhibit integrin-dependent human neutrophil aggregation and polymer nuclear influx, PMN influx, in COX-2 and NPKB knockout mice. Arginine, this amino acid, helps in the healing of wounds, aids in cell division, helps remove ammonia from the body, facilitates immune function, and helps increase secretion of hormones such as growth hormone. The body also needs arginine to manufacture nitric oxide, which it uses to keep blood vessels dilated, assuring proper oxygenation of the heart. Arginine, taken with ornithine, aids in the synthesis of growth hormone carnitine. Carnitine is an amino acid used by the body to release energy from fat. Supplemental carnitine has been shown to improve the ability of carnitine tissue to produce energy and has been shown to reduce muscle soreness caused by exercise. Immune system, EPA, eicosapentaenoic acid, inhibits the growth and metastasis of some forms of cancer. EPA enhances the function of disease substance lipids. EPA functions as a precursor for the production of further super unsaturated fatty acids, serious 3 prostaglandin series, 3 thromboxanes, and series 5 leukotrienes. View echo the pentanoic acid metabolic pathway. EPA inhibits these potentially toxic substances, enzymes. EPA inhibits, retards the production of lipoxygenase. This is desirable due to the lipoxygenase stimulating the production of inflammatory leukotrienes lipids. EPA prevent the release of arachidonic acid from cell membranes, thereby preventing the body's manufacture of the toxic inflammatory prostaglandin E2. EPA inhibits the production of prostaglandin F2 alpha. EPA inhibits the body's production of thromboxan proteins. EPA lowers apoprotein A levels within the body. EPA lowers fibrinogen levels within the body. EPA noticeably increases blood sugar level and decreases the secretion of insulin. Cancer prevention. Glutathione function protects white blood cells, promotes immune function, rehabilitates antioxidant vitamin C and E, helps in the production, deafens and repair of DNA, protects against ultraviolet damage, binds and helps remove toxic heavy metal, lead, mercury, arsenic. Soy and genistein. Genistein suppresses the production of stress proteins, GRP, glucose-related protein, and HSP, heat shock protein, is a protection against cancer, especially chemotherapy and radiation. Eicosanoids are fatty acid derivatives that play a key role in mammalian cell signaling, primarily in oxidative pathways, prostaglandins, and related eicosanoids are responsible for tissue responses such as inflammation and wound repair and are increasingly implicated in many of today's most common diseases such as atherosclerosis, Alzheimer's disease, rheumatoid disease, and cancer. COX-2 is an enzyme that plays a key role in the biosynthesis of prostaglandin, found mainly inflammatory and immune cells. It is also suspected to play a role in the control of cell growth. Some human tumor cells produce high level of COX-2, a special class of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs has been developed that act as selective inhibitors of COX-2 activity. COX-2 levels are increased in nearly 85% of colon cancer. Biochemical evidence that the oncogene HER2 induced overexpression of COX-2 suggests that inhibitors of COX-2 might be the therapeutically useful in the subset of women having HER2 positive breast cancer. flavonoids in milk. Thistles seem to have special affinity for type 2 estrogen receptor. There is also emerging evidence that milk is thistle extract is a COX-2 inhibitor, another example of its smart selective action. Flavonoids, lignans, and the importance of glutathione. Both flavonoids and lignans are often loosely grouped together. With isoflavonoids, soy, phytosterols, and comestans into a category of compounds known as phytoestrogen. Structural and chemical similarities between flavonoids and human steroid hormones and thyroid hormones are particularly intriguing. Lignans have potent hormone-like properties and are now beginning to be studied in relation to cancer and immunomodulation. Flavonoids are part of a larger group of important compounds known as polyphenols, widely distributed in the plant world. Together with chlorophyll and carotenoids, flavonoids are the most common pigments in the plant. All flavonoids show various degree of antioxidant activity. Flavonoids stabilize cell membranes, probably thanks to their ability to protect lipids against peroxidation. Typically, flavonoids also decrease the production of nitric oxide in excess. Nitric oxide promotes chronic inflammation and the generation of more free radicals. There is also evidence that indicates that certain flavonoids, including those found in wine, tea, and coffee, can chelate iron, which can act as a powerful catalyst of free radical-induced damage. The ability to chelate iron further enhances the ability of flavonoids to decrease oxidative stress. The most potent flavonoids may even extend lifespan. Very likely, their mechanism of action extends beyond the scavenging of free radicals and reducing inflammation. Flavonoids also modulate the action of various enzymes, such as lipoxygenase, which catalyzes the oxidation of polyunsaturated fatty acids, leading to the production of harmful inflammatory compounds known as leukotrienes. Some flavonoids slow the activity of the main phase 1 enzymes, the cytochrome P450 system. This means a slower conversion of various procarcinogens into carcinogenic metabolites. Anti-inflammatory properties, like many other flavonoids, silibinin can also inhibit the production of nitric oxide. Excess nitric oxide can be very destructive. It triggers chronic inflammation and promotes the generation of more free radicals. Silibinin's anti-inflammatory properties are also of great interest. Silibinin can inhibit the formation of pro-inflammatory prostaglandins too, but there is some evidence that in liver this takes place only at very high concentrations. On the other hand, silibinin excels at inhibiting the lipoxygenase pathway, thus reducing the generation of harmful inflammatory compounds called leukotrienes. The inhibition was remarkably strong at higher concentrations. Silibinin lowered the leukotriene levels to 2,896 of the control value. The powerful reduction of leukotriene levels by silibinin is of great clinical interest in the treatment of inflammatory disorders. Silibinin inhibits the production of nitric oxide, a destructive compound that can trigger chronic inflammation in skin cells. The flavonoids in silmarin appear to inhibit the cyclooxygenase 2 enzyme, thus leading to a lower production of inflammatory prostaglandins. Bioflavonoids, a large class of compounds derived from fruits and vegetables, includes limonene, hesperidin, and rutin, all from citrus. Decreases arachidonic acid release, decreases histamine release, exhibit a wide range of antioxidant activity, including the protection of collagen and hyaluronan from free radical attacks, strengthens capillary and vessel walls, works well with vitamin C dosing 250 and 1000 milligram. Turmeric, aka curcuma longa, a spice of whose active component is the yellow pigment curcumin, possesses powerful anti-inflammatory properties by inhibiting lipoxygenase, cyclooxygenase, and phospholipase A2, thus turmeric disrupts the arachidonic acid cascade. At three important steps, possesses the ability to scavenge nitric oxide, demonstrates antioxidant properties by both inducing glutathione production and quenching free radicals, reduce neutrophil cascade to areas of tissue injury, decreases platelet aggregation, Boswellia serrata from the leaves of trees in central India, blocks the enzyme lipoxygenase, thus reducing leukotriene production, decreases lymphocyte migration to inflamed tissue, has been used for both osteoarthritis and rheumatoid arthritis, can suppress connective tissue degeneration during inflammation. Ginger, a spice that interferes with the cyclooxygenase enzyme, thus reducing prostaglandin and thromboxane production. Rosemary, fresh or dried leaf of Rosmarinus officinalis, has both antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties, neutralize nitric oxide and peroxynitrite radicals, protects DNA from xenobiotics. COX-2 is short for cyclooxygenase 2, one of the key enzymes that helps the body produce inflammatory hormone like compounds called prostaglandins and cytokines. COX-2 is essential. Without it, we wouldn't be able to fight infections or heal injury. But when the body overproduces COX-2, the result in chronic inflammation and pain. Too much COX-2 appears to result from imbalances and deficiencies of certain nutrients. Vitamin C is a potent antioxidant that scavenges cancer-causing free radicals, neutralizes carcinogenic chemicals such as nitrosamine and nitrites, and regenerates active vitamin E in lipid membranes. Vitamin C regulates inflammation by increasing synthesis of prostaglandin 1, anti-inflammatory, and inhibiting prostaglandin E2 inflammatory. Vitamin E has been shown to be one of the strongest protectors against the environmental pollutions, ozone and nitric oxide. Nitrites are major source of free radical damage to cell. Nitrites form with amines in the gut to form carcinogenic until they are converted to an active form in the body. Free radicals as messenger role of active oxygen species in inflammation. Inflammatory cells, granulocytes, macrophages, some T lymphocytes produce active species of oxygen as part of the microvicidal cytosidal system. In turn, active oxygen species can modulate specific elements of the inflammatory response. In vitro examples include protein immunomodulator substances such as granulocyte migratory factors, prostaglandin cyclic nucleotides, as well as formic elements such as platelets. Many antioxidants can act as prooxidant by, for example, reducing non-radical forms of oxygen to their radical derivatives. Particularly if redox cycling occurs, the exact mix of pro- and antioxidant properties of a reducing compound is a complex interaction involving pH, relative reactivities of radical derivatives, availability of metal catalysts, and so forth. Melanin is important because it is the only biological polymer which is a stable free radical. And was the first free radical established in biological systems. Free radicals are produced by environmental causes such as light or ionizing radiation. However, three physiological processes can result in extraordinarily high level of radical species. These include the mixed function oxidase system or endoplasmic reticulum, the NADPH, NADPH oxidase system of inflammatory cells, and the presence of high level of antioxidation mediating charge transfer agent, production of activated species by such mechanisms can exceed the capacity of local protective mechanisms and produce tissue injury. Inflammatory cells produce active species of oxygen in antimicrobial defense. One to while such species may directly damage surrounding tissues, their major secondary role may be to mediate important components of the inflammatory response. Antioxidants, superoxide dismutase, and catalase have significant anti-inflammatory properties. It is reported to be both safe and effective in the treatment of various inflammatory and degenerative lesions in men. Many other anti-inflammatory drugs may also involve interactions with the active oxygen system. Such agents may act by interfering with the action of phagocyte-produced active oxygen species, variety of active oxygen-generating agent can produce fibrotic change. Examples include oxygen itself, paraquat, nitrofurantoins, and bleomycin, which produce pulmonary fibrosis, the third major mechanism for endogenous generation of activated species, is by auto-oxidation catalyzing charge transfer agents such as copper, iron, or manganese. Free radicals participate in many positive reactions as mitochondrial respiration, prostaglandin synthesis, platelet activation, and phagocytosis. The engulfing and destruction of microorganisms and cellular debris. These highly unstable electrons can cause extensive damage to lipid membranes, organelle structures housed within the cell body, and DNA itself. Thank you very much.